everybody, we're playing Elden Ring. And today we're going to head back to the starting area in Limgrave, and we're going to head to the coast, on the west coast, which is over by the beach. Use one of my golden runes. I can do some leveling. Endurance gives me more stamina. Still showing heavy load if I put the pants back on. Cloth ones are okay. Might change the tunic as well. For the Kaiden armor. Looks pretty cool. Still on a medium load. Actually, those Kodrick gauntlets are better. Medium load. Head. Ugly looking thing. Yeah, still can't wear the helmet without going to heavy load, so I'll just take it off. Okay. Heading west towards the beach. Now, there is a spot here on the cliff where you can drop off. Something down here on the end of the beach. Guarded by the undead. Oops, I swapped my weapon out. Okay, a gold pickled fowl foot. Yeah, underneath here is a merchant. Let's go and see what he's got for sale.
What do you need? I don't want any trouble.
Broadsword. And squirts. Stone digger trolls. There is a bow here too. I'm going to sell some golden runes, which really is the same as just consuming them. And then buy the armorer's cookbook.
Well done. Well, be on your way then.
Hope you're looking donkey. Some demi humans here. Rainbow stone. Let's check up along the beach and see what else there is down here. Land octopus down here. There's this invisible beetle here. You have to stand in the path. Here it comes. No, I missed it. No. we go. Stamp sweep. So this green path here leads back up to the top where Limgrave starting area is. And we have a troll. Easier to fight on horseback. The target lock. Okay. Anyway, let's head back down to the beach. And down the end here's another Caden warrior. And an item. Triple white flesh. Okay, that's the end of the beach. Now I'm going to look for the coastal cave. Because there's a boss in there that we want to defeat. And also we can head through to somewhere where we can sell our dragon heart. This will be of interest to spellcasters mostly. But I do want to defeat the boss in here. Head back down to where those demi-humans were, which is about here. Here's a fellow we've met before. Yeah, it's very dark in here. Try target lock. think I'm going to go and find the lantern next episode. This swapping back from the torch to the weapon and back again is kind of annoying. You can buy an item called a lantern, which allows you to keep using your weapon. Okay, I think this is where the boss appears. Yep. We have two demi-human chiefs. Oh. Okay, that was my first try. So great. Let's try again. I should come in here in a minute. Here he comes. Nearly got him. Okay, let's try again. Bleed on me as well. Of course, whenever I heal, they come at me, so a little bit tricky. Tailoring tools and sewing needle. Those items will allow you to change your gear. Fireflies here. Okay, what does it say? Oh, of course. So there's a fast exit right here, but I'm just going to keep going. Because this coastal cave has two ends to it. Let's have a bit of a look around the island. There's a ruined temple up here, the site of grace. It's the Church of the Dragon Communion. This is an important place once you've slayed the dragon to come here. You'll have a dragon heart that you can trade. Funny that all the statues have no heads. Someone's come through and cut them all off. Okay, this altar here. We can trade our dragon heart for one of these incantations, so dragon fire, takes faith 15, arcane 12, dragon claw, faith 17, arcane 13, and dragon maw, faith 24. I'm going to go for the lowest one because I'm not really a caster. Go for the dragon fire. General's dragon to spew flame breath. Sounds interesting. Great dragonfly head. Here we get the Somber Smithing Stone, rank 1. Nice view. Don't think there's anything else here. I'll head back to the mainland. Let's level up. I'll consume some more runes. Actually, that should give me 2 levels. Go for dexterity. And bigger. That's the end of this episode, guys. Thanks for watching. Click like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.